Our Saturday Night Live ain't no Josh Chicago dance party.
And now, what and now.
What the
Chicago?
What the
hot? And now.
Hotness. What the
hot? And now.
The hotness.
And now.
On WBMX FM Oak Park, Chicago. We'll be right back.
102.7 FM, BMX. You're with Armando. Let's get back in the mix with the winner of our Battle of the DJs.
Saturday Night Live, ain't no John Chicago dance party.
BMX.
107 BMX.
Shut up, man. You cut the small talk, all right? Now I got a deal for you.
It's dog or something, Dan?
No.
Deb, you want a nice hot Italian sausage, maybe? Okay, chill.
My objective was to find the right combination of mixed show jobs for different pockets of the metro area. I want the best guys I can find. I was looking for something unique and different. Stop. And that would represent the whole metro area of different lifestyles and approaches to the same music. We ended up with the original Hot Mix 5. It was Kenny Jam and Jason, Ralphie Rosario, Father Jack Masterphone, Mickey Mixon Oliver, and Scott Smoking Seals. When I had my first meeting with these guys, I explained to them, this is the birth of something that can really be big, but it was up to you in terms of where you would take it. We really tightened up the mixes and everything was really gelling at that time, number one. Number two, we did research and we were playing the hottest shit alive at that point. The jocks were on point, the promotions were on point. We were a great sounding radio station. And it all came together at the same time. As time went on, the Hot Mix 5, I think they got into the record business, producing, and recording, and pressing, and you know, distributing their product around the country. The impact of what they started, what they did, still today, you just don't know. I mean, we had broken through into new territory. When I left Chicago, went to San Francisco, and I've told this story to only a handful of people, but it's a story that will live with me forever. I was the program director of KNEL, which is at the time a kind of a crossover top 40 station. I went out for lunch one day on Pier 35, the station was right near there. And I walked across the street to get a hamburger, hot dog, and the guy out there was, do you remember those multicolored afro wigs you see the idiots at the football game here? Well, this guy had one of those on. He was selling cotton candy and hot dogs. I used to have a girl like that. And he had a ghetto blaster, and it was loud to the point of distortion. It was just incredibly loud. And I hear this Saturday night live. Ain't no party. 102.7 BMX. I said, you know what? I'm getting home. I'm starting to hear my old story. And, you know, wow. Wait a minute. I heard that. I went over to this guy and said, hey, man, what are you listening to? Where did you get that? He goes, man, my cousin lives in Chicago and sends me tapes every week. This is a cassette. It's the best station in the world. They're going to play the best jams. You know, it's like, you can't get this anywhere, man. This is outrageous. I said, yeah, I know. That's my station. I used to work there. I was a programmer. Yeah, okay. You want a hot dog? What do you want? I said, no, man, you don't understand. I said, that's the station I just left, and, you know, I built this whole Hot Mix 5 thing and all. He goes, yeah, okay, right. You know, it kind of rubbed me wrong. So I said, okay, yeah, all right, give me a hot dog and a Coke, and I'm out of here. I go back, I go to my office, I pick the phone up, and I call Armando. I said, Armando, I want you on the plane this Friday. Bring out the tapes. We're going to put a mixture on Candia. But he brought his tapes out, and we played them. And I went back that next Monday, the same guy. I came back the same day, and I told him I was going to do it. He goes, yeah, okay, cool, I'll listen. So he did. When I came back, he was completely, his attitude changed. He goes, man, I can't believe you. So you don't realize what you just did in San Francisco. San Francisco will never be the same. Boo, boo, boo. I said, yeah, right.
What sauerkraut?
And then out of his mouth next, what do you think he said? Can you give me some tapes?
Give me some tapes.
Give me some tapes. I have been in New Orleans, L.A., New York, Miami, Atlanta, Houston, Texas, and the same thing. The ripple effect of what happened at WDMX in the 80s went all over the country. The philosophy, the attitude, the right mix for what's happening today. Yeah. I remember running into Elroy at Summerfest up in Milwaukee, and I ran into him backstage. What's with this Hot Mix 5 thing? What does that mean? And I looked him straight in the eye. I said, Elroy? He says, they want to come on the stage. I'm like, yeah, I'm not sure about it. I said, Elroy, I mean, don't think about it. Leave the concert now. Go and put those guys on and watch your radio station go. Okay? And he said, but why? He kept asking me, why? What makes them so good? What is it? I said, don't ask any questions. Just do it. Trust me on that. I'm telling you from experience, it's magical.
WVMX FM 103, Chicago Central Music. Tune in now.